Hi, and welcome back to another Spine Tips video. Today, I will show you how to set up inverse kinematics, also known as IK. You will find this useful in just about every spine project. In the last video, we made a hip-spine-shoulder setup. This time, we will make a hips-legs setup. If you watch these two videos, you will know how to make a basic bipedal skeleton. Let's start. This will be our walker skeleton. Click on the body slot and create a new bone. Call it cog for center of gravity. This will be our main body controller. Change the color and icon so it's easier to see in the tree view. Click on create and with cog selected, make another bone beneath the cog bone and call it hips. Now let's make leg bones. With the create tool active, hold control and click on the leg image. Then drag to create bones. Selecting the leg image this way names our new bone and moves the image under it. We have all our bones in place. If we go to animate mode and try rotating the legs, they will rotate using forward kinematics or FK. We want to animate fast and efficiently. So it would be great if when we move the cog bone, our legs would be bent so the feet stay planted on the floor. This is where IK constraints come into play. Select front thigh and front shin. Click new IK constraint. And click the front shin to create the target bone exactly at the tip of the shin. This will prevent the bones from moving when the target bone is created. Rename the target to front target. Let's do the same thing for the back leg. What we have works, but we want the foot to follow the target bone. For that, parent front foot under the front target bone. And do the same for the back leg. You can use the hotkey P to set parent. The last thing I want to do is make a mesh out of the feet so the toes can bend. Select the front foot image attachment, make it a mesh and edit it. You want to have more vertices where the bend will happen. Click the right mouse button to toggle between modify, create and delete tools. This will do for now. Close the edit mesh mode. Now open the weights view. Click bind and select the front foot and front toes bones. Click bind again and spine will auto calculate the weight. Let's do the other leg as well. That's it. Our walker skeleton with IK legs is done, fast and easy. Let's go to animate mode and do some tests. Your IK constraint also has some attributes. You can flip your constraint if you check the positive checkbox. You can enable stretch if you want stretchy legs, which is very useful for cartoony characters. Stretch is not applied if softness is greater than zero. You can add softness to slow down the rotation as the bones straighten, which can prevent popping knees in walk animation. And lastly, you can mix between your IK and FK legs. This very simple setup provides a lot of possibilities. Have fun and happy animating!